anybody from Table 5 want to give a well wish?
Good evening. I am the cousin of the bride. And I wish she and her husband all the best, and that they will continue to love each other. And as I told her on Friday, that nothing is easy. You know, we're gonna have trials, but we must always come up on top. And I also told her that if the both of them have been a disagreement, don't ever go to their bed without not talking. So good luck.
That is right. And I'm sure that all the married people in the house can attest to that, right? Yes, I'm not married as yet, but who knows, soon. What about Table 12? Look at all of these lovely persons. Anybody here would like to give a well wish? All right, lovely lady in green, clap her, please.
All right, so I'm a friend of both Wayne and Sash. I met them about 2 years ago. I think one of my memories with them, I think we were taking a road trip one day. For all of you who know Wayne, he's a bit extroverted and, you know, he loves to talk, while Sash on the other end, she's quiet and very introverted. And I remember, I think, Wayne was talking about football, and I realized that Sash was getting a little, you know, like, Wayne, you're talking a little bit too much now. And Sash reached over, and she touched Wayne as if to say, all right, Wayne, I eat that now, eat that. So that's one of my memories with them. I just want to wish them all the best. I said this to Sash, but I also want Wayne to hear it. I'm not married as yet, but advice that I would give them is that it's not going to always be 50-50. A lot of people think that marriages are always 50-50. There are going to be days when it's 70-30, 80-20. And, you know, it's as long as you have God in your marriage and you love each other enough to work it out, then everything will be good. So that's all I want to say to them.
Now, man, in the clap partner, man.
Yes.
Now, man. All right. No, sir. Oh, now nah, eat. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Nobody not answer me. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening.
My apologies. Maybe got in the phone when the parents tell you to say you enough to talk while you not eat. I'm going to stop share the soup. So everybody look for me. Please share the soup. Because I don't like the looks I'm getting. How are you doing tonight, everyone? How are you doing tonight, everyone? Wanna stop, make me a beg on if you respond to me. Please. How are you doing tonight? On a hungry?
Yes.
Wanna say on a hungry?
Yes.
So never cook no Sunday dinner. So wanna come here tonight? Be Sunday dinner. Is that right? I'm assuming that the waiters have been assisting you, especially those of you whose belly is making that noise. Please silence it. We appreciate it. I hope that the servers are assisting. Are you being served right now?
No.
Is there anyone who has not been served as yet? Or they're going to get the food by tables. That's why me love their table one. Want nobody at their table one? Only not smart. As you have me there 15, me come right, just so come sit down. Only not necessary. Anyway, we just ask you to just wait for us a moment. As we continue our section, we want to hear from you. Tell us something nice, but not in a lie. Tell us something nice. You gotta try. If we not laugh, you have to go get all our money. Go ahead. We never say you have it, me say you're going to have to give it.
Oh. Hello, good evening. This is Table 2, and we are the family of the groom. Junior, what can I say about him? Junior is a humble guy. If you give him $1, you can stretch it to $100.
Oh, yes.
You know, I remember back in 2019, I think it was December, he said that he wanted to experience the cold weather in New York. And when he came to New York and he was there, I said, you're not coming with me, let us go out. Let's go to the supermarket or something. He said, Auntie, me not go there because it's too cool. Me can't deal with it. So me said, then Junior, you know, so you want to experience the weather? So if you stay inside, you're going to get it. He said, Auntie, me not go there. You know, me tell you, shoot, me staying here. So everything Junior wants, I have to buy it and bring it inside to give it to him. Say that to say this, Junior is a very humble guy. And trust me, I do not know much about Sash, but I know that she got a wonderful husband.
Anybody agree to that? If you don't agree, clap her, no, man. Oh, so that side, yeah, the part for the groom. Ooh, so that side, you don't support the bride? You don't support the bride? You don't support the bride? Oh, so somebody wants, is he getting a wonderful wife? No, no, hold on, hold on. Is he getting a wonderful husband this side? Is she getting a wonderful husband? No, I mean, if you know who I'm going to say is stronger, is he getting a wonderful wife? No, sir, I love that, sir. Is Wayne getting a wonderful wife? No, I'm hear the yes, but I have an earphone. I can't hear with earphone in. Is Wayne getting a wonderful wife? Yeah. Sorry. Is Sash getting a wonderful husband?
Of course, we train the best.
No, sir.
We have the best men in our family.
Yes, sir. Who that?
The
stand
best
up.
Men
stand up.
In our family.
Come, stand up now.
Stand
Mr. up.
Mr. Bedward, my Come. Nephew.
Yeah.
Your friend.
Yeah.
Your daughter. Your niece,
yeah.
Your daughter, again, your granddaughter is getting a wonderful,
yeah.
Wonderful,
say that wonderful
husband.
Again.
That's my nephew. We train the best, respectful, mannerable, humble, hardworking, dedicated. Don't let me start right here.
Come on.
Better don't no, let start. Me start.
No, stop. Hey, no, sir. Sorry, let me this mic. Somebody have to do better than that for the wife. Who going to outdo that? Yes, see her here now. Come, talk up, lady. Come, stand up and talk. Make them see you in your nice dress. Come on, show off. Oh, God, she look good. She not look good. Not to me, I talk. On the clap on her, man. Yeah, man, she look nice. She look nice. She look nice. Come, tell them what Wayne is getting.
I am Sashana's aunt.
Yeah.
And Wayne is getting a lovely wife.
Oh, sir.
She's the best. He could have never got another wife like Sash.
Nothing
like Sash.
No, sir. No, sir. Hold on, only not done it. They not done it. That's what I said. They know. Come, hold this. Come, pass it on. Come, tell them over there, so what Wayne is getting. Tell them.
I'm Sash Hunt.
Yeah.
I'm Sash. And Wayne?
Yeah.
Never get a woman like that. Never be so clean and a man beside Wayne.
No, sir.
Wayne are the first.
Yeah.
I might be the last.
Mercy.
But he never get nothing like that before.
Oy. No, sir. Let me just. No, I'm not trying to cause rivalry. But when the key can't make that win over there, so who's going to speak on Wayne behalf? No, when the key can't make them win over there, somebody have to talk. No, when you not talk, who going to tell? No, come, yes, man. Somebody have to tell them over there. Tell them what Sash is getting, because they don't believe. Tell them.
How do?
Yes.
I am one of Wayne. Granduncle.
Yes, sir.
That means to say.
So you know for sure.
Yes.
Yeah.
I am Wayne, father, uncle.
Yeah.
I am Wayne, father, mother, brother.
Yeah.
Right. So yeah. Granduncle. Well, as you can see, I am a very handsome young man.
Yeah, master. Are you Wayne get the look, sir?
Yes, that's what I'm gonna say. So Wayne is a handsome young man. Let me stand up in front.
Yes, sir.
Junior is a handsome young man.
Wait, now make them see your suit.
turn home and make them see a suit. No, sir, him look good now too. Yes, man.
Yeah, man, so.
Yeah.
Miss Sasha, you're getting a real handsome young man to be your husband.
Yes, sir.
A real great young man. We're proud of Junior. We're proud of him.
Yeah.
And hope you, his wife, family, will also be proud of him. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Una clap him, na man. Una clap them, na man. What you say?
One more.
Come on, you have to tell them. Yes. Tell them.
Yes.
Go ahead.
My cousin good.
Go.
My cousin smart.
No,
my cousin educated.
Yeah.
My cousin.
Yeah.
Is very, 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 very. What me want say? Help me.
Come now.
Right. He's a good man.
Yes.
He's a kind soul.
A kind man.
He's a gentleman.
Yes, sir.
She is getting a wonderful, God-fearing
Mercy.
Husband.
Yes.
In Jesus' name.
Yeah. A clap her down there, sir. Man. A clap her. No, listen, before, I don't want any fight going in here, but even the can, I'd appreciate it. So, like, we still hear one more. You want to tell him? Tell him, please. Tell him.
Good evening, everyone. Come, listen now.
Una make them win over here, somebody else ask. Una make them win over here, sir. Una have nothing more to say? No, sir. Go ahead. There's so much of them attack. You want another talk? Me know you take it up. Come, your time.
All right, so I'm going to use a song to describe Sash.
Hold on, music coming. Music man.
Selector.
DJ. The DJ.
She kissed me first thing in the morning. Then she said, baby, have a good day. She not hear from me, she'll be calling. Tell me what more can I say? He's like I want 100 million.
No, selector, they say you have to pull up. No, sir. Only better find a better song, you know, because them can't win. Yeah, but selector, we're going to play that one more time. But 1 second, selector, 1 second. Can I talk to you for a moment, people? Let me tell you this. Only let me in the ears 1 minute. I'm telling you this. None of my friend now start no more life. And then I have some money. So I'm money pull up with the pan. So who can go on? The bank account details soon come. Who no want to put the money up here, sir? We send the bank account details. I mean, I check it because I'm going to have to transfer. Because my friend want to start life with at least one TV in our room for watch. And if you name me by the TV, all married couple know very well that him going to need a bed. No married couple in here. All married couple know say he will need a bed. Oh, on the silence, make me know one thing or not think, you know. But DJ, give me that song one more time. Play that song one more time.
Then she said, baby, have a good day. She not hear from me, she'll be calling. Tell me what more can I say? He's like I want 100 million. I found a good woman. I found a good woman. Like I want 100 million. I got a good woman. I got a good woman.
Hold it, DJ. One more voice. And then after this, me don't want too much excitement done so early, you know. It's nice already. And the bride and groom, they will come in. Come, my friend. Last voice. Go ahead.
Hello, my friend. It's the bride aunt. Because, you see, we ain't get the Virgin Mary.
Mercy.
Yeah.
Nothing better than that. You have to say nothing else.
Yeah.
You win.
You get the Virgin Mary. And when you go have one baby boy.
No? Yes. Mary. Must. No, play that song one more time, DJ. Because it look like him win 100 million for two. In the meantime, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to permit you some time to have some soup. And I have one more person who say, it can't do nothing, I mean, say something. So in the meantime, take your time, have some soup. Like the soup, we've just done the appetizer. The best is yet to come, only thing. No boring here. Me say the best is yet to come on the thing.
My nephew is a sweet little bunununus boy and he's a virgin too, so it's two virgin me together.
Oi, sir. Things are talk up in here. DJ, play one song, yeah? Play one song. Ladies and gentlemen, just take a moment. Take a moment and have some soup. You got to sip that one because it might be hot. Sip that one because it might be hot.
Natural beauty, you know. Tell me, no, I've never been someone shy until I seen your eyes. Still, I had to try, yeah. Oh, yes, let me get my words right and then approach you. When I'll treat you like a man is supposed to, you'll never have to cry, no. I know everyone can relate to when they find a special someone. And she's royal, yeah, so royal. And I want her in my life. I never know anyone so one of a kind, no. The way she moves to her own. She has the qualities of a queen. She's a queen. Ooh, ooh. What a natural beauty. No need no makeup to be a cutie. She's a queen. She's a queen. And when they ask what a good woman's made of, she's not afraid and ashamed of who she is. She's royal, yeah, so royal. And I need her in my life. I never knew anyone so one of a kind until the night that I seen her eyes. Supreme. I can see it in her eyes, the way she smiles. Hey, yes, I and I know the king and queen crown, see I'm tired, so I'd never leave your side. Just stick with me through the trial times. Oh, and she says she no mind. Correct, I know good man is hard to find. And she can't about that giant line. That's why she has no ties at this time. Yeah. I know many men are trying, but she needs to be more than wine and dine. Because she's royal, yeah, so royal. And I want her in my life. I never knew anything
when she moves to her own beat. She has the qualities of a queen, so supreme. Ooh, ooh, what a natural beauty. No need no makeup to be a cutie. She's a queen, so supreme, yeah. And when they ask what a good woman's made of, she's not afraid and ashamed of who she is. She's royal, yeah.
Wow.
Amazing how this world was made. I wonder if God is a woman. The gift of life astounds me to this day. I give it up for the woman. She's the constant wind that fills my sail. Oh, that woman. With a smile and a star, she'll protect you like a child. That's a woman. She'll put a smile upon her face and take you to the higher place. So don't you underestimate strength of a woman. Morning, I got up with a scent of a woman. Just picture if you would what life would be. Ain't much good without a woman. She can nag and be a constant pain. Oh, that woman. Those hips, she's got me whipped, and it's just too hard to resist. What a woman. Hey, she'll put a smile upon her face and take you to the higher place. So don't you underestimate the strength of a woman. Strength of a woman.
soul, baby. My heart beats for you only. Every word is true. I'm in love with you. Take you as you are, lady. You ain't gotta change for me. Need you from your crown, honey. Right down to the sole of your very feet. Girl, my love grows stronger each day, baby, please. Don't hurt me just because you know I forgive. Girl, my love grows stronger each day, baby, please. Don't hurt me just because you know I forgive. For you only, every word is true. I'm in love with you. Take you as you are, lady. You ain't gotta change for me. Need you from your crown, honey, right down to the sole of your very feet. Girl, my love grows stronger each day, baby, please. Don't hurt me just because you know I forgive. Girl, my love grows stronger each day, baby, please. Don't hurt me just because you know I forgive. Together the storms of life, forgive. Oh, won't always be sunshine, baby, we're blends of imperfection. Oh, 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 give me your heart and soul. Love me like you've never loved before. Beautiful morning dew, I'll be your shoulder to cry on to. Girl, my love grows stronger each day, babe. Don't hurt me just because you know I forgive. Girl, my love grows stronger each day, babe. Don't hurt me just because you know.
girl for me in Jamaica, Lord. Hey, she have a rich history, a beautiful woman with the sweetest gifts. Beautiful sunrise and an evening kiss of a nice sunset on the evening season. But she tell me say she tired, tired of the exploit and the liars. She give them reggae, give them beaches, give them flowers and the ferns. All she got is abuse in return. But I say, don't you worry yourself, mama. Hey, Chronix is here to your help, mama. Ooh, I said, no worry yourself, mommy.
Greetings, world. No MSG, no preservative, no additives, no nothing. Just the way we are. Check it out. Oh, gosh, man.
Tyrus Riley, just the way you are.
Woman, I love you. Yeah, you have your own style. She wants to be like them people on TV. She wants to look like them girls in the magazine. I got to love ya, you know me love ya. Yeah. Hey. She wants to be like them people on TV. She wants to look like them girls in the magazine. She got I'm on a
to and do what you want to. It's no concern to me. Come and have my own vision, me depend on my own mission to rule my destiny. Oh, it's my day to do anything I want to. It's my time, and I'll use it any way I want to. It's my life, and I'm responsible for every action. It's all mine, my day, my time, my life. I beg you, easy now, give me some reason now. And don't invade my space. I'm in a different place, different face, moving on my way. So if you feel like a champion and nothing can go wrong, this one is your song. Hey, put away your troubles, put away your worries, help me sing along. Oh, it's my day to do anything I want to. It's my time, and I'll use it any way I want to. It's my life, and I'm responsible for every action. It's all mine, my day, my time, my life. Out there, feeling alive, feeling a vibe, and nothing can stop me. I don't care what they think or what they say about me. Look out, world, here we come, up and running. And all I'm saying is, it's my day to do anything I want to. It's my time, and I'll use it any way I want to. It's my life, and I'm responsible for every action. All mine, my day, my time, my life. Chimney, give thanks for life. Give thanks for life. Chimney, chimney. Oh, yeah. Give thanks for life. Give thanks, I'm alive.
Give you more again, yeah, yeah, yeah. You never find no one in this lifetime to love you like I do, so never mind things that people say that I'll never hurt you. You never find no one in this lifetime, so never mind, let time unwind. To rest, baby.
Baby,
let us put love to the test, baby, and let love lead the way. If we believe, join our hearts, mind and souls, keep us together. You never find no one in this lifetime to love you like I do, so never mind things that people say that I'll never hurt you. You never find no one in this lifetime, so never mind, let time unwind. Baby, when time comes around and no one's around, I'll be there with you, girl, in silence or sound. Time after time, things burden you down, but I will still love you, love you. Our friends say that you are not sincere.
Ladies and gentlemen, I want him like with MC, you know. Ladies and gentlemen, I want him like being MC. About being an MC, that I get the chance to say ladies and gentlemen, and then everybody pause and look. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know, looking same way. I mean, I appreciate it. Thank you very much. All right. So, I know it's late, but we have to have some excitement in here. I want to say about that. Yeah. No, I mean, in a boring crowd, anybody boring, this is not the place for you. I say, it's late, but we have to have some excitement in here. Yeah. All right, my mom not in a Sunday dinner yet. My mom not in a Sunday dinner yet, and I'm in charge. You know what I am? The master of ceremony. So let me go again. It's late, but we must have some excitement in here. All right? If the soup can bust the gas, I'm going to show tonight. Me say, I know it's late, but I must have some excitement in here. All right, we're getting warm. One more time. We're getting warm. I know it's late, but we must have some excitement in here. All right, that one was so weird. No, because Sash looks so good, we have to do it better than that. I know it's late, but we must have some excitement in here. All right, we're almost there. We're ready now. We're ready now. So, just on the outside is a wonderful party of people who accompanied the bride and the groom this evening. And I'm going to introduce them for you. I maybe not be able to introduce them adequately because they are indescribably irresistible. They are wonderful, beautiful people. And starting the pack, leading out, is the one and only best ball upon the field. And walking with him is the one who, despite the nighttime, is always shining. It is Dushan Harriet and Sashana and Chantel. Sorry, cut that, musician. Let me write back from the script. Ready again. From the one and only Dushan Harriet and Chantel Codlin. Run the tune of DJ, let me sit them. Half a dance. Una half a dance, cause una know what Wayne can do well. Una know what Wayne can do well. Run the tune, DJ. Whoa. Yeah, the sound, so the man. Oi, yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yeah. Yeah, right to the seat. You can't stop. Yeah, 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 yeah. Oi. Yeah. Yes, sir. Yeah, straight to the seat. Give us something. Do something. Give us something. Right there. Don't move. You can't move yet, son, till I'm not finished. I'm not finished. Yes, sir. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yes, sir. All right. I'm here to expose all the church people tonight. Following the son is none other than preacher Dennis Reed, and with him, the sister of the groom, Jeanette Bedward. Yeah, yeah, keep it going. Yeah, yeah. Anyone know Dennis can dance? Go, Dennis. Yes, sir. Yeah. Yeah, all right. Ready now? Yeah. Yes, sir. Yeah, 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 yeah. Watch Dennis! Whoa! No, sir! Alright, it's getting nice in here. Following Dennis is the one and only Matthew Ruddock with his Kenesha cousins. Alright, we're waiting on the dance. Yes, sir. Yes, Matthew. Matthew, let's go. Oi. Hey, yeah, yeah. Yes, Matthew. That's it. Yes. Oi. Show them how to dance, man. Yeah. No, sir. No, sir. Come. Yeah. Come on stage now. One more time at the people's seat. Give us the dance now. Turn to them now. Let them see you. Give us that dance now. Let's go, Matthew. I won't press on them. They're tired. Take her to her seat. And last but definitely not least of the, and coming following after them is Joanne Bedward and Sinead Parker Phillips. Clap them, no man. Come on. Yeah, that is what's up. Now you have come down the aisle too fast. You have to go stop on the stage. We want to show the dance. Come, give us the dance right there. Dance right there. Yes, sir. Yeah. Want to see what the bed we are doing? We are known to do that too. And then we have the maid of honor and the best man. That is Lashana Cousins Miller and Mario Brown. Clap them now, man. Where the excitement there? Come on. It's a whole heap of work to become best man. That must be known and made up on her. Clap them again. Yeah. Yeah, one more there. Made up on only can't stop so quick. A big position, Nina. Give us some dance. Yeah, Mario. Show them, Mario. Show them, Mario. Yes, Mario. What's Mario? Boy. Yes, sir. That's it, Mario. All right. Yeah. Yeah. Silence in the building. Silence in the building. DJ sound the big thing them. DJ has a sound the big thing them. Cause this big thing are going on now. Everybody please stand. Wanna have some manners and respect. Wanna stand down on your feet. And we must start clap right now. Start clap right now. Start clap. Me not hear the clap and the scream it. Yes, man. Yes, man. Put your hands together for the first time in here tonight. Mr. and Mrs. Bedward. You can't stop clap, man. You can't stop clap. Clap them. Wayne, show us that dance, Wayne. That one. Yes, sir. It's your dance. Take your time with him, Sash. Take your time. Yeah, Wayne. Yeah, Wayne. Yes, Wayne. Boy. Yes, sir. Take your time. No rush. It's your night tonight. Yeah. One more. Show them what they can do, Wayne. Show them what. Show them one more time, Win. One more dance right there. You can't move yet. It's your night tonight.
I give you peace of mind.
Yes, sir. Come on, sir. Show them says yes. Yes, sir. Boy.
Our connection is rare to find.
That's it, sir.
That's why.
Yes, sir.
I'm gonna let you go.
Come on now. Yeah, no. Yes, sir.
Right there when you need.
Yes, man.
Yeah.
Boy. Turn around, Sasha, and look at him now. You maybe you see, oh, wanna sit down already. Oh, wait, wanna sit down? No, wanna get up back, we're not sit down yet. Wanna wait on the turn. Wait to no turn. Wait, don't sit down. Everybody still sit down. Wait, wait. Wait, and stand up and wait till them take them seat, man. And show some respect, man. Show some respect to Mr. and Mrs. Bedward. All right, Wayne, you first, you and your wife first, take your seat. Yeah. Only, rest on the can sit down now. Rude, you know, rude. You must know on the place. Again, it's good to be here. I must go ahead first and tell you this. Before I go further, I must share this with you. I've known Wayne and Sash for quite some time now. Maybe not long enough, but definitely our friendship has transcended years. Connection is bigger than any timeline you can consider. And I've seen them make a lot of decisions in their life. Some hard, some difficult. Some, you know, may not have gone so good as they want, and some that is excellent. And I must tell you, I'm here tonight witnessing them make the best decision of their life, making me their MC. I can't think of anything better tonight. And so, as I'm the MC, it is good to have you all here celebrating with us. I wrote something down, but my last paper. Why am I kill this, sir? Me need to do better. Maybe that's why I'm not married yet. But I wrote down this is the definition of love. Listen, the message says, love is a heterogeneous conglomeration of absurdity that bamboozles the autonomy of the individual who has been intoxicated. Why not look at me so I couldn't have a clue what me I say? Oh, you don't know what love is?
No.
Love is a feeling you feel, and you know when you feel it, you know that you're feeling it because you've never felt it before. That is all I said a while ago. So I'm saying that love, that heterogeneous conglomeration of absurdity that bamboozles the autonomy of the individual who has been intoxicated, is being celebrated tonight. We need a clap if you don't understand what it means, you know, me watch. And I found that in love, my friends, love has started the hardest battles of life. Love casts the hardest and heaviest pain. Love carries the heaviest burden. But can I also be honest and tell you, love is the best thing known to mankind. And as a preacher, can I be honest with you and say to you that everyone that loveth is born of God and knoweth God, because God is... Wait, no, no, there is text. Can I say it again? Everyone that loveth is born of God and knoweth God, because God is... Tonight we are here to celebrate love. And so, God, ladies and gentlemen, just take a moment right now tonight to put your hands together and just celebrate love. Clap love. Because love is the best thing known to man. I've seen some of the greatest men thrown down from their throne simply because of love. And many who have been uplifted simply because of love. I pray and hope that every one of us in here gets the chance to celebrate love. If not tonight, if not anytime, tonight and for the rest of your life. Only can clap, please. So there are some simple rules. Tonight people will be giving toasts. Every time I count 1, 2, you are supposed to say ah. After 2, 1, 2. Aww. No, catch it here. The bridal party knows very well how the ah is supposed to sound. So let's go again. After 2, 1, 2. Aww. All right, that is practice. Can everybody go again? After 2, 1, 2. Don't worry, I will give you the cue, and every time you count, you give that sound so the place is excited. Now, I know that many of us have come here tonight waiting for our Sunday dinner. I'm sorry for the vegetarians, because I noticed on the menu that there's only the blessing of the meat. Thus, anyone who is vegetarian tonight, your food is not blessed. But I want the service to start sharing, so can we all just close your eyes as I pray for the blessing of the meal? Let us pray. Let us pray. Divine God, as we pause to celebrate love, that thing that you have bestowed upon humankind to experience, we ask God that you send your angels down in here, that your Holy Ghost will saturate this place in excitement of what you, God, has created. Then we ask simply that you bless the meal that we are about to receive, and may it fill our bodies so we can create even more excitement tonight, we pray in Jesus' name. I kindly ask the sir. I'm not 100% sure, but I think it is buffet style. Am I correct? It's buffet style. So I think it's buffet style. So it's table by table that you should be heading to the person. So I ask you to go. I'll call you all two by two, and you all head to the table. As is appropriate and as I believe is correct, I'd like to ask table one and table two to first head to the... Sorry, there seemed to be a moment of mix-up. They're still serving the head table? Okay, if the head table is still being served, we're going to take a moment to have a little bit more excitement in here. Is that okay with you, brethren? I'm sorry, I'm not church media. Is that good, ladies and gentlemen? Yeah. Don't worry, the food going to reach your table. We promise. If they don't put any food at your table, they should put at mine. And if they put a food at my table, that is divine. All right? So as we are here for this moment, I was telling my friends that one of the things that shocked me about Sash and Wayne's relationship is I don't understand quite how they work. Because usually in relationships, female talks a lot. Ladies, do you agree? No. Men, do you agree that females talk a lot? Some of the men very quiet because somebody sit inside of them. Am I correct? Ladies have a tendency to do the talking. And men are about action. Don't agree, men? Men who can't big up on themselves. Men is about action and women about talking. Not true me a talk. You don't have to frighten if you who side down. Not true me a talk. Yeah. What? Don't answer because I'm not going with you tonight. So you must know. But one of the unique things about this relationship is that has anyone here ever called Wayne to have a 5-minute talk? I'm sorry, some people laughing. One day, I called Wayne simply to ask him if everything is okay. I ended up speaking on the phone for 3 hours. And the only question that I have not asked is if everything is okay. But that's the time. And so, what I wonder about this relationship is how the conversation goes. Because... Well, then again, Sasha's not necessarily a talker, but I hope she has very good listening ears. Not you, me, a talk? Yes. I hope she has very good listening ears because Wayne have the tendency to have very decent... I want to say it. Conversations. Providing a necessary point. But Wayne, tonight I have one piece of advice for you. One piece of advice for you. There is a magic phrase that you must learn when you're going to wedding. I'm going to marriage. It's something you must say at the end of every day, every conversation, before you go to your bed, every night. This simple phrase, yes, dear. Now, all the single people now get it, but when the time will come. A As I share with you, I have one more thing I must share tonight. I have one more thing I must share tonight. And don't worry, I will rush on with the program shortly. But I have one more thing I must share tonight that I want Wayne and Sash to know. I've come to the realization there's something critical that Wayne must know. And that is that whatever happens in the home, he must never finish first. Who over there saw a laugh? One thing Wayne must know that starting from tonight going forward, he must never finish. Anybody else understand what I say? He must never finish. Why must he finish first? Why he must not finish first? Why Wayne must not finish first? Not what? He must not. Nothing that happened in the home, he must finish first. Especially when he goes home tonight. You say if him can finish and start again, it's different. I don't know about that. What I understand from conversation is that Wayne must never finish. Unless the lady said, I must tell you, unless him can finish first and second. That's not possible, sis. Wayne, don't go home, go finish. Sash, don't go home and make Wayne tell you, say, him done. What a piece of excitement in here. So I must ask, how are we with the food? The head table has still not been served as yet. All right, DJ, can you give us a few songs? Can you give me one moment as we get a few songs in? I have some things I want us to do, but only can't do it when you're not hungry. Because the hungry thing not going to work. A country you come from. I'm going to eat nothing from evening. Yeah, you're going to eat from morning. Me kindly ask you know, to can just move a little bit quickly so we can get the head table served. Serve this lady because I share the excitement tonight. And just make sure everybody get food and they're well restored because we've been waiting for long. All right? DJ, can you play that song for me, please?
Hold on,
you like they don't understand. Let me tell them. When you hear the cup and glass and knock, is one thing that means when your lips must meet Sashana own. All right, let's go again. Run that song.
Keep his mind on nothing else. He'd take the world. strong. Yeah, yeah. She is always in my corner right there when I want her. All these other girls are tempting, but I'm empty when you're gone. And they say, do you need me? Do you think I'm pretty? Do I make you feel like cheating? I'm like, no, not really, cause oh, I think that I found myself a cheerleader. She's always right there.
Testing, thank you. Microphone testing, thank you very much. Hi. All right, everyone. I know you're here sitting down, you want some entertainment. And so, to entertain us tonight, first we have a musical selection by Mr. Errol Martin. He will come and give us some music. Can you make some noise for Mr. Martin? Want to make some noise for Mr. Martin now, please? Meanwhile, Mr. Martin is setting himself up. I must give the bride and groom some a bit of advice. Number one, listen. Number one, a husband is like a fire sash. Are you hearing me, Sash? A husband is like a fire. He goes out when unattended to. Understand that, Sash? Yes. So learn to attend to your husband. Listen to this one now. Keep your eyes wide open before the wedding and half shut afterwards. Next, listen to this one. The best way to get most husbands to do something is to suggest that perhaps they're too old to do it. You hear me, Sash? All right. May I teach you? Don't forget this thing too, right? You know? Listen to this one. Listen to this one. Husband and wife, listen to me. There's this quote that says, a heart that love will always be young. Want to hear that? Want to hear that? A heart that loves will always be young. So take care of his young heart. Even when you see he's getting old, or it seems he's getting old, and even if his hair is together. All right? Listen to this one. Your words are my food, your breath my wine, you are everything to me. All right, Errol, are you ready? Go to Errol, please.
One, two, one, two. Hear me now. Many did try but couldn't steal my honey. All right, let me say it nice. Gotta play it twice. Think all of them. Hey. Hear me now. Many did try but couldn't steal my honey. Many did try but couldn't get her love. Some fools they tried to trick her with their money, but turn around and wondered what she's made of. She just loves this groovy little thing we got going, and it will last as long as our hearts are beating. She just loves this groovy little thing we got going, and it will last as long as our hearts are beating. Yeah. Many did try, but she just wouldn't leave me. Many did try to tell her lies about me. Some things they said, God knows it hurt me. But with a smile, she just ignored their silly try. She just loves this groovy little thing we got going, and it will last as long as our hearts are beating. Hey, say she just loves this groovy little thing we got going, and it will last as long as our hearts are beating. And she just loves this groovy little thing we got going, and it will last as long as our hearts are beating. Yeah. She just loves this groovy little thing we got going, and it will last as long as, hear me now, say, no separating me and my lady. We firm as the rock of Gibraltar and mountains around Jerusalem. You labor in vain if you try to bring us pain, cause in every way you cannot go round us, she said. Nothing divides us. We got more than a million reasons to quit, but we will never quit. More than a gazillion reasons to quit, but we're holding on, cause love is what dreams are made of. And in my visions all I see is her. We got something strong, and so we holding on. I tell her, say she loves this groovy little thing we got going, and it will last as long as our hearts are beating. Say, she just loves this groovy little thing we got going, and it will last as long as our hearts are beating. Yeah. Ease out.
Testing 1, 2. All right, so we are now ready to serve. We ask those at table 1 to come, please, as we serve your food. Please remember to walk with your plate. Thank you very much. Table 1, followed by table 2. Table 2, you can come to. Table 1 and table 2. Please, let's make this quickly. It's already very late. Table 1 and 2. Table 1, table 2, table 2, you can come, please. Table 2, you can start here. Thank you. Table 3 and table 4. Table 3 and table 4. Sorry, can you move it a little bit alacrity? Time is fast spent. I wanna have a baby, I wanna be part of you. The good, the bad, the old. I think we can take table 5 and table 6. Table 5, table 6. Table 5, then table 6. Based on the numbers, I think we can take table 7 as well. Go ahead, table 7. 5, 6, 7. Table 7. Walk with your plates. Remember to walk with your plates. It is critical for you to walk with your plates. And those of you, there are two sections for serving, please. You can go to any of the two. You do not have to be on the left. Please take the server of the right. Those on the number 7, table number 7, please go to the right section, please. Walk with your plates. Yes, there's two sections for serving.
Love your brother, love your sister, love one another, the universal time. I take it from here.
Alright everyone, just listen to me for a few moments. What's happening is, in the interest of time, we will have to do some multitasking, if that is okay with you. That's okay with everyone? We're going to have to do some multitasking, which involves us having our meal, as well as listening to the speeches, the toasts, and creating the excitement in here tonight. And so, I hope that you are not too bothered by the fact that we needed to participate while having lunch. Forgive us if it means a little bit late. Delayed, but definitely not denied. And that's all right. Just remember that the food is from Wayne and Sash, and this is their treat to you. Remember to treat them too. I just got their banking details. I will share with you shortly so they can have that nice bed that they need for tonight. Right, Wayne? So as we go forward into the program, right now we will take the toast to the bride from Lashana Cousins Miller. Can you welcome her to the stage, please? Come on, we can do better than that. Welcomes Mrs. Cousins Miller to the stage, please. Put your hands together for her.
Good evening, everyone. First of all, I would like to thank you all for coming here to celebrate this beautiful new marriage. I also want to specially thank the persons that are here with us from overseas. We appreciate you taking the time to come here and celebrate with us. For those who don't know me, allow me to introduce myself. My name is Lashana Cousins Miller, and I am the older sister of this beautiful bride. When Sashana asked me to be her maid of honor, I was so honored and extremely pleased. So it means the world to me to be standing here supporting her tonight. Our relationship has always been solid. She has always been the perfect middle child and the best little sister you could ever ask for. I've had the pleasure of witness her blossom into this radiant young woman I watched her grow up through her. I've had the pleasure of witnessing her. I've had the pleasure of witnessing this radiant bride grow up through her life. She's a grand young woman. She's beautiful and strong. And I can tell you, she has learned from the best. That's me. Our connection as sisters has been anything but inseparable. Especially as she grows older, our bond has become stronger. My sister has always been the more quiet, reserved lover of God, and she's also so meticulous in her life choices. Didn't I tell you that she learned from the best? So when she chose Wayne for her life partner, I had no doubt that she was making the right choice for her. It's a cliche to say that it's a match made in heaven, but sometimes cliches can be literal. Sis, our mom would be so proud to witness all that you are and all that you has become. But of course, we already knew how special she was. She is loved and cared for unconditionally. And I want to thank you, Wayne, for taking her as your bride. And going into your new married life, I know that you're both going to nail every aspect of this husband and wife thing. You support each other. You have a strong bond that is imaginary. And beneath all the love, you're great friends. And with God as the captain of your life. Wayne is a great person, having met him, and he has helped her to blossom. That's really my job, but thank you, Wayne, for taking that weight off my shoulder. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together and toast to my sister, your beautiful bride tonight, Miss Sashana Cousins Bedward. Missy, thank you.
I know we eat it, but we can do better than that. Clap her now, please. Thank you very much, Mrs. Cousins Miller. You trained her well. Since you are married, you figure more or less you need to marry too, not true. As we move forward, we will now have the toast to the groom. Mario Brown, the best man, will deliver the speech. Mario then say, must tell the truth. Mario then said, we tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth.
Good evening, everyone. So my name is Mario Brown. So when... So Wayne has been my best friend for the past 16 years. And words can't explain how much I really love and appreciate him. It was a really sad day when I migrated. He was crying, I was crying, but we've been friends for a long time, and there's not much I could put in words or on paper because it's a long time. Well, I've watched him grow as a Christian and as an individual, and I can say he's willing to work, and he'll be a great husband for Sash, because he'll always pick up for her. The first time I met her, Wayne and I were actually arguing because she was late. We were going somewhere and she was late. She was late, so he and I were arguing. So it wasn't really a great first meeting for us, but everything went well. So, and I've watched them grow together in love and harmony, and I wish them nothing but the best. And I wish you all the best, and with God's guidance, I know that this love will be a long-lasting one. Amen.
We passed table 8 already. And table 9, when we get food already too. 10. When we see table 12, I eat. 13. 13, my belly full. 14, well, I'm banning the rest, so that means them I get them food. Table 15, I'm banning the rest, so neither. All right, has all been served? Has all been served? No? Who not get? Who not get? All right. Has all been served? The lady at table 10 says she wants, 11 says she wants a second one. Thank you. All right. If you haven't, if your table number has not been called, please go to the servers right now as we move forward the program, please. Thank you. I hear everybody talking about growth. About growth. And I must share this with you, my friends. I must share this with you. Wayne is a friend of mine. That Dushan and I, Dushan and I play football. By the way, Dushan is like a short one here, so he barely made it over 4 feet. Sorry, this is Dushan. Dushan and I play football together, and while playing, we decided to invite Wayne. And the first day Wayne came to the football field, I asked Dushan if he knew what he was doing, and Dushan said yes. So I see Wayne pull out him two left foot to go play football. And may I tell you the truth, he couldn't control, he couldn't pass, and he couldn't even run properly. But as time progressed, I see Wayne by himself a football. Wayne start practice to kick the ball upon the wall. And then not just that, then Sash came into his life. And Wayne start have good control. Good pass. Wayne start shoot and Wayne start score. It's as if he was practicing for something. Wayne, don't be careful of the field you go on. I know you have a plan to go on a certain football field for a night activity. You will shoot and Sasha don't know how it going to go. But you must sort out the scoring. What you say, Mario? 1-0. That's all they need. 1-0. All right, as we go forward, can we have the toast to the bridesmaids by none other than Sunshine, Chantel Codling? Put your hands together for her, please. Come, Sunshine. Can you clap her some more, please? I know you're eating, but please clap her so she feel welcome. Clap her, man.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, let's give it up for Jamaica's newest couple in the house. People, people, Mr. and Mrs. Bedward. Woo! Yes, 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 yes. It is a wonderful pleasure for me to give toast to the beautiful females on this bridal party. Oh my God, you're looking so gorgeous. Yes? Are true? Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to talk with me. But everybody busy eating. But that's all right. But what I really want to say this evening is that I want to thank God for allowing Sashana to choose these beautiful ladies. There, I think personally that God would have allowed her to choose each and every one of them because they would have given their utmost support to Sashana and Wayne while planning this beautiful and grand occasion. And I must say too that the support will not stop here. The support will continue throughout their marriage life, throughout their childbearing life, and even to old age, don't it? I think so too. And let's just raise our glass to Mr. and Mrs. Bedward this evening. I know that heaven is smiling and so am I. Cheers to you and cheers to the beautiful ladies on this bridal party. Thank you.
One, two. We're not going to stall because time is far spent. And so I find this rather telling that right after Sunshine, Miss Sunshine, we have, is not Mr. Sunshine? None other than Dushan Harriot, and he will give the toast to the groomsmen. Please welcome Dushan. Now, can you please welcome Dushan? Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm in feed tonight. I know saying all right, to separate a man from him food, me understand. But tonight is about Mr. and Mrs. Bedward. So I'm asking you please to welcome Mr. Harriot as he toasts the groomsmen.
Thank you, Mr. MC. So all protocols observed. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. So I have one simple task this evening, to give a toast to the groomsmen. So at this time, I'm going to ask my groomsmen to please stand. Gentlemen, come on, man. Yes, including Mario. Ladies and gentlemen, aren't they looking exceptional? Sharp, dapper. Look on the man. Yeah. All right, man. You can't sit down. So, so I'll start with Mario. Wayne's best man. I mean, Wayne would have said, thank you for your unwavering support and commitment. I mean, this young man, as he would have said, has traveled all the way from overseas just to be here. I remember when Wayne proposed, and for some reason Mario didn't know at the time. Mario was vexed and said, no, this can't happen. No wedding can't keep me another best man. So, I mean, it just goes to show his love and support for Wayne. And so Mario, we thank you for your continuous support to Mr. Bedward. Next we have his younger brother, Joanne. I mean, I've been there and I've sat and I've listened and I've watched sometime their conversation. And it so amazes me that when they are having a conversation, it feels like Joanne is the older one. I mean, the level of support and knowledge that he passes on to Wayne sometimes, it's not anything bad. It's actually something good. It just goes to show that in Wayne's corner, he has good support, even from the youngest coming up to the oldest person. And so, Joanne, we thank you as well for accepting the call to be on the groomsmen party. Next, we have Matthew Ruddock. This young man, I recently met him. Matthew is one that is humble, and he is someone who is very, very reliable. And I am sure, see, Wayne shaking his head, he is very, very reliable, especially when it comes on to the school season. Trust me. Matthew is very, very reliable. He's a constant friend, and he's traveling all the way from Westmoreland. Give him a clap, ladies and gentlemen. He shows his love and support. Last night when we were at the rehearsal, and he came on the St. Thomas Road, and when he came, we were like, boy, how you make it? You know what Matthew said to us? Bro, I have to be here. It's all about love.
And so, Matthew, we thank you also for being here. And next, we have Mr. Reed, Dennis Reed. He is the one that keeps Wayne in check. In check, I mean... He and Wayne is always at it. But they are always at it. But one thing I admire about them, you see, they have a good relationship and good conversation. You see, when they knock head together, trust me, they are a powerful duo. I won't say couple. They are a powerful duo. And I really like that, and I appreciate that about Dennis. He's always a constant support in Wayne's life. And so it leaves only me. Yours truly, Dushan Harriet. I mean, what can I say? If you ask some of our other friends, they will tell you that I am the father of them all. I am the one that keeps them level-headed. And so I am proud to be Wayne's friend and to be a part of his groomsmen party. And I would not have been anywhere else but here tonight, because Wayne means a lot to me. And so I thank you, Wayne, for picking us to be amongst your groomsmen party. And so as I close, I just want to say to you, young men, as the word says, as the first part of the word says, groomsmen, it says groom. We have a responsibility as men, as friends, and as brothers to continue to guide Wayne as he moves in this new part of his life. I mean, we can only do this as well through the help of the Holy Spirit. And so, gentlemen, our work has just begun. Let us stand beside Wayne nonetheless and continue to support him. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together as we toast the groomsmen tonight.
Why am I just Chantel over there, so I smile. Places are bright up like sunshine. Yes, yes, sir. All right. I want to share something with the. There's a little poem that I drafted up. I want to share with the bride and groom tonight. It is this simple. Love is giving, not taking. Mending, not breaking. Trusting, believing, never deceiving. Patiently bearing and faithfully sharing. Each joy, every sorrow, today and tomorrow. Love is kind and understanding, but never demanding. Love is constant and prevailing, its strength never failing. A promise once spoken, for all time unbroken, a lifetime together. Love is time and forever. No, sir, may I give up now? No, sir. Are the best thing that me have in a book, you know. Maybe just go down, let me look for a Bible scripture. Maybe that can help, you know, start off the church. Let me tell you a scripture, say 1 Corinthians 13, love is patient, love is what? Kind. It does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily. Oh, no, no, that part of it. Thank God. Love does not delight in evil. Man, may I give up non-counting, even when it takes. But rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. Love never fails. If I even amen, you know, could I say? Love never fails. Amen. Thank you. No, sir. Take care of that. At this time, we take a break from all the talking as we listen to some melodious music from the one and only
Mr. Alex. He is a singing bird, and he will give us some entertainment tonight. Please make welcome to the stage, Mr. Alex. Can you make welcome to the stage, Alex?
All right, so the song that is about to be sung was a request by the groom, so do enjoy. Mrs. Bedward, this one is for you on behalf of your husband.
Sunshine on a cloudy day. Although it's cold outside, I've got the month of May. Well, I guess you say, what can make me feel this way, my girl? Talking about my girl, I've got so much honey, the bees envy me. I've got a sweeter song, baby, than the birds in the trees. I guess you say, what can make me feel this way, my girl? Talking about my girl. Ooh. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey, hey. I don't need no money, fortune or fame. I've got all the riches, baby, one man can never claim. Well, I guess you'd say, what can make me feel this way, my girl? Talking about my girl. I've got sunshine and a cloudy day, baby, my girl. I even got a month of May. Talking about my girl. Talking about my girl.
Give it up for Alex one more time. All right, so we move to the toast. We continue with the toast. As we toast the bride's father, Miss Melissa Marshall. Is Miss Melissa Marshall here? Yes? No? Can we have the toast to the bride's father? And in the meantime, Mr. Alex, get yourself ready, because I understand that you are doing the toast to the groom's parents. Thank you. Clap her, please. My apologies.
Don't worry yourself, Mr. MC. I have that effect on men. All right. Good night, ladies and gentlemen. While I was sitting there in the crowd, I heard a lady. I did not get her name, but she mentioned how beautiful you look. Let me tell you something. She did not lie. Standing here looking at you, y'all look gorgeous. Give it up for yourselves. All right. Let me personally congratulate the newlywed. Congratulations to Sash and Dwayne. Can I invite Mr. Cousins to stand, please, and thank you. Hello, again. I am Lisa, cousin of the bride, and it is my absolute honor and pleasure to be given a chance to propose a toast to my uncle, the amazing one in a million father of the beautiful bride. Mr. John Edward Cousins, you are the epitome of all that a great father should be, and you have been like this from the very beginning. I would know, as these are from my earliest memories. You are strong, firm, stern, grounded, a man of character, a man of high value and morals, a protector, a provider, but most importantly, you are a leader, and in the eyes of your precious children and family, especially your children, they are just grateful God handpicked you so they can call you dad. Because of your unwavering love, support, wisdom, and guidance over the years, they were able to develop and flourish into all God called and created them to be. Thanks to the giant of a man and father that you are, and the exceptional job you have done and continue to do in raising your family, not one, follow me, ladies and gentlemen, but two of his three daughters are now married. The proof is not in the pudding, but it is in the proof of your daughters. You are a wonderful man, Uncle John. So tonight, right in this very moment, not I, but the entire room declare you should be not one, but the absolute proudest father here tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, can we raise our glass and toast to the father of the bride? Hear, hear. Thank you.
That was wonderful. And a clap her now, man. Come on, a clap her now, man. A toast to the bride and, sorry, we now move to the toast to the parents of the groom, Mr. Alex. Wanna clap him now, man? Sure.
All protocols observed.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's an awesome privilege that we are all gathered here to celebrate the personification or the physical attributes of love in this man, Mr. Wayne Bedward, and Mrs. Sashana Cousins Bedward. No. We are here to celebrate the Bedwards, the newlyweds, one of the greatest couples that I can say I am proud to call my friends. And, you know, just being here this evening, I want to salute the father and the mother of the groom, Mr. Wayne Bedward and Mrs. Claudia Bedward. We salute you, parents, for all your hard work and your dedication in making Wayne a great son, a great friend, and I am proud to call him my brother from another mother. So raise your glasses with me as we celebrate the parents of the groom, Mr. and Mrs. Bedward. Nah, man, that can't work, man. Make some noise, people, on the boring saw. Thank you, man. Sure.
Thank you very much. I know time is fast spent. And so I don't want to have you delayed here too long as we seek to go home with great haste. I want us to move directly to the table as we focus our attention over there at the table. And we just want to just ask you to just clap for the next 30 seconds for the persons who prepared the cake as we are thankful. I'm going to clap the people that will prepare the cake. There is much more to be said, and I can't say it now, so I'm going to clap them and give God thanks. Clap them, man. Clap them, man. Clap them. Much more could be said, so clap them. All right. So Wayne and Mr. and Mrs. Bedward, sorry. Not the ones down there, the ones up here. Tonight, the crowd is asking that you give them a taste of some certain things over that side. So firstly, Mr. Wayne Bedwell, what they're asking you to do is to take your wife to the cake. I won't tell you how. You must decide. But take your wife over to that table where the cake is, sir. Wow, this seems serious. They move the chair out of the way. Yes, sir. All right, gently. All right. All right. We in a cancer rough with her. Take your time. One lady said something over there so earlier, you never there. All right. All right, so there are a few things, you know, there are a few ways I know to do this. And I know that this has to be done in the best way. And so I want you to look over there. There's a knife over there, right? Mr. Bedward, take up the knife, sir. All right. I want you to stick the knife somewhere in the cake. All right. Are you satisfied where it is, sir? That you're good with that. All right, no problem. Mrs. Bedward, put your hand on the knife. Thank you. Mr. Bedward, give her the hold you think she deserves now. He moves the clothes out the way and he positions himself carefully and he rests his hand on hers as a symbol of togetherness. I say to you now, after three, listen, Wayne. Listen, Sash, it's after three that you can count, that you can cut the cake. Are you ready? Count with me, everybody. One. Come on, I'm not hearing you. After one is what? Two. It cannot be that. It must 1.5. Come again. After 1.5 is what? Two. It must be 1.75. After 1.75 is what? Two. We don't know that. After two, then we have what? Three. After three is what? What come after three? Four. After four is what? 1, 2. All right, now listen to the instructions, Sash. There's a little plate there. There's a fork there. Okay, I want you to cut the slice of the cake you want to give to your husband tonight. You must know if it's a small size or what have you. All right? I want you to take out that piece and put it in the plate. You see how she gently and carefully measured the amount she wants to give him tonight? When you're watching, brethren? I want you to take the piece of the cake that is in the plate and put it in your mouth. Excuse me? And the MC, you do as I say. Why you ask me? Nah. If you want to chew it, that's your choice, you know. If you chew it, that's fine. Sash, you think you have enough? You ready? All right, Wayne. Wayne said that's not enough. You're not ready. Sash, Wayne not satisfied. You have to give him more. One thing I know, Sash, one thing you're going to have to learn is that you have to satisfy the man. So, I don't know, we might have to cut piece more of the cake. Cut the slice he needs. All right, she cut a bigger slice. Yes, sir. She learning fast. Only say yes, sir. Yes. All right, she takes it out carefully. All right, sir, put the cake in. Yeah? Yes, it's good to talk about it. It's good that they're talking about it, not you. All right. So, Wayne, is what you're leading over there. What's happening? No, I didn't give you any instruction. Take your time, sir. You must wait. You didn't wait. Wayne, like you want to put it in your mouth too fast, man. Take your time. Sash, look here, Sash. The people want to make sure you have cake in your mouth. Right. Good. So, Mr. Wayne, I'm sorry. Sash, I want you to feed your husband like you'd want to feed him. No, man, no look at excitement. Wayne, you get enough? You're good at that? All right, Wayne, I'm going to ask you to just carry out the same. Give your wife just what she deserves. So I want you to cut the cake. No, oh, there's a slice in there already. She cut for both you and I already, Wayne. What a big piece we ain't take off. No, sir. She nervous. It too much. Wanna clap them now, man? Very good. Where are their wine glasses? Can we ask the best man to carry it across, please? Take it to them, because one of the things we want is that there's a unity. The two of them, best man, not just Wayne Glass. Thank you. So the first thing I want you to do is, Wayne and Sash, listen to me. The first thing I want you to do is to feed each other. No, sir. Yes. Wayne, feed Sash. Sash not getting any win. Wayne, you're alone. I'm getting Sash not getting. All right. See that Wayne is sharing. I like this couple. Do you notice that how they're working it out together? And when one mess up, they fix the problem. This is how the relationship is. Let's go now, Wayne. Let's go. Right. Take the time and win. Sasha getting? Sasha getting over there, sir? Yes. All right. You know, clap them now, man. The next thing I want you to do is to put your hand between each other's hand and feed yourselves. Right. Because the thing is, in a relationship, you want to feed the next person and want to, through unity, develop yourselves. Let's go feed yourselves now. Clap them, the brethren, please. Clap them, the man. Clap them, the man. All right, Wayne. We don't have long, but there's a certain thing that everybody in here has been waiting to see. And so, I don't know if they can put a chair right here at the front. You want to put a chair? Put a chair right. Can I get a chair right here at the front, please? Somebody. Anybody. Just put a chair right there, so at the front. And Sash. Sash, I want you to, right there at the front where they can see. Good. That do, yeah, it might, I don't want it to fall off, so let me just turn it sideways. No. Huh? Sash, come, Sash. Take a seat, man. In fact, yes, Sash. Sash, come, take a seat at the front, right there. Right there. Right there, Sash. No, go ahead, Sash. Go ahead, Sash. Have a seat right there. There's, you guys don't know. Wayne, stop right here, sir. You guys don't know, but there's something that Wayne did to win Sash. And he's going to do it tonight. There's something that Wayne did to win Sash. The DJ says the bitch track. Don't worry. That's, you remember that thing that you did? The truck, DJ, you have the truck ready? DJ, you have the truck ready down there?
Ready.
The one by Lenny Williams. There's this truck. There's this truck. Please find that truck. I'm going to show. Many of you don't know Wayne's ability, you know. It's the thing about when he grows and develops and he will do anything to get the wife or the thing that he wants to get done. And there's something he did to win Sash that you all must see tonight. You don't want to see it? So I want to clap and make some nice, no man. Boy, sir. Hold on, DJ. Don't rush it. Don't rush it. Sash, you have your seat now? Wayne, you ready? Wayne, no, under this first. Under this first, Wayne. No, under this first. Under this first. So you need to, there's something she have you have to go for. Oh, him taking off his jacket. Him no. Yes, sir. Come. Come, Mario. Him said, come. Yeah. 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 Boy. All right, man, warming up. Come on now, yeah. You cannot go for that thing no way. Remember, you can't use your hand. Just a reminder, this is not something your hand can help with. Yes, sir. Wanna clap now, man? Wanna clap now, man? Yes, sir. Move her foot out the way. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You never know so hard. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You find it, Wayne? What Wayne did to win Sash. That truck. You're ready now, Wayne? Where's the mic? Let me give you my mic. Go ahead. Your time now, Wayne. On a clap, Wayne, the man. He's the man of the night, you know. Everything Wayne do is right tonight. And is good. All right? We Wayne, you ready? All right, Mario, setting up. Ready? See the mic here, Wayne.
All right, so before I start this lovely, lovely, lovely selection, right, I just want to tell everybody thanks. Planning this wedding has been really rough, to be honest. It didn't go 100% as planned either ways because we should have been out here from 9 o'clock. But guess what? We are married and we're going home tonight, right? Yes, yes. So at the end of the day, that is what matters, right? So I just want to tell everybody thanks for being here, for taking time out, to my family that travel overseas, my best friend that travel overseas, my other friend that he had to leave because he's from Westmoreland. I just want to say thanks. I just want to say thanks especially to a friend of mine, Mr. Norman Smith. And you might be wondering why I'm giving Norman a special thank you. It's because it's the first from I know Norman until now. I see Norman works so hard as it relates to this wedding. You know, and I have to say, Alex, big up, right? Big up. To the how the food tastes? Food tastes good, don't? All right, so I have to big up my friend Shana Sierra Dero. She's around by the back. That she is the one that basically prepared the food and make sure that the food is good and everything. I want to give her thanks. Brother Lynch. Yes. I want to say, bro, thanks. Thanks to the Woodburn SDA team. I want to say thank you. And then, guess what now? There's somewhere that I need to big up also, Pops. Yeah. I have to big up Pops, you know, you see? You know, when I remember when I was going to propose and I sent Pops the video of the ring, Pops said, yeah, man, do your thing, man. Go enjoy yourself, you know? You know, Pops, I have to tell you thanks, you know? Thanks for your daughter. You did a very, 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 very good job, you know, my friend. I tell you, I cannot complain, you know? You know, one of my friends normally say, you know, Wayne, it's like God literally looked down on you and unpicked this one for you and just give you this one and say, my brother, hold on this one and don't let go. All right? So, Pops, respect. To the family of the cousins, they traveled from Portland to be here. And trust me, I know that the road from Portland to St. Thomas is kind of rough. Am I right? Yes, kinda. But they are here also, and I just want to give them thanks. Tell them thanks. And you see this table right here? This table right there? Yes, Uncle Sonny, Auntie Millicent, my cousin them, you know, that table right there, I can basically say that table is fresh from Norman Manley International Airport, same way, you know, and they're here with me. You know, when I was talking to my cousin, he was saying that, boy, Junior, you know, I have to try get the time off, you know, it's going to be rough, you know, but guess what, even if you have to fly in the Friday and leave the Sunday night or the Monday, we will be here, you know, and because of that, I really appreciate it. And how can I forget the camera crew, Jovan, Romario, Elder Campbell, I want to tell you thanks, John, big up yourself, my G. You know, pick up yourself always. Then we have Brady run by the back. Selector, Brady, pick up yourself. And then I cannot forget one person. You know, when I'm going to tell you the honest truth. I was worried, you know, and she said to me, Wayne, I got you. I know what I am doing. Just don't worry yourself. Just enjoy yourself. And I was up here and I was, you know, there in my thoughts. I see I get a text message and say, you need to smile. You know? I am talking about none other. And you see, my brothers and sisters, I want to tell you something. You see, when I just got engaged, she was just willing to help. You know? Just say, what are your colors? We don't know nothing about color. We don't know nothing at all. And trust me, Fatie was there to help us straight through. And she came here and she decorated the air and she decorated the church. And my brother and my friends, the place look good, don't? Yes. And for the person that made the flowers, Sister Duncan, I do not see her, but Sister Duncan has also helped us and give us some advice as it relates to the wedding. And my brothers and sisters, it's been tough and it's been rough, but I just want to say thank you all for being here. All right, I don't miss nobody. Okay. No? You see, I was trying to cut the speech short, but I can't cut it short again. So we have to just start, no? All right, fine. So let's go down the track then. All right, so mommy and daddy. Hey, I'm going to tell you another joke now. You see, when I'm in my bed, my mother can wake me up 4 o'clock in the morning, you know, man. And say, my son, come here in my room. I say, mommy, what is it? So mommy say, listen to me. What is going on with this wedding? You need to talk to us from now. My brothers and sisters, hey, friends. I don't know what I tell her in the 4 o'clock, you know. I don't remember what I tell her. But guess what? Mom and dad, 100% support. You know? 100% support. And even as it relates to my dad, I don't see daddy. Daddy, you never sit down right here, so daddy. That, all right. You see, for my dad, especially, I just want to say, Dad, it's been a rough few months, right? And let me tell you something. It's one thing with my father. You see, if I have to spend him last to make sure that not even me, any one of his children, them happy and all right, even if I am last, my friend, and him can't buy food the next day, he's going to do it. Yes, that is one thing with dad, right? And I also want to tell my family now, because you see, when I try to cut it short, they get in a problem. So I want to tell my family now, especially I have a cousin here. This is her second time, right? Her second time in Jamaica, right? And she's here. And I have to see her, you know. I'm sorry, so I have to go up on honeymoon because I'm going to carry up on a tour. You know, but we soon go tour, yeah? And I also want to thank my aunties. This table right here, for those who don't know, is a sister table right here. This is a sister, you know? All sisters. Huh? One man in the lot. I remember. I'm getting there. You see, my brothers, you see, friends, this table right here. This table, Sash, you see, how I know how to treat a woman comes from this table right here, You know, they groom me. And let me tell you something. You see, same way, oh, I said I'm going to cut this short. And you see my auntie say, hey, what you just do? Trust me. You see, behind the scenes, I would probably get a little bit more box up and some conk. You know, they have really been there for me. And I really appreciate them. And let me tell you something now. You see, the one big man you see right here. You know, let me tell you something. It's one thing I want to take from Uncle here. You see, oh, uncle always make my auntie smile right over here, so, you know, want to make sure someone makes her smile, so you hear? All right? Every time I see Auntie Norma, you know, Auntie Norma just bright like a diamond, I'm telling you, you know. And it is because she has someone in her life. All right? All right. So, all right. All right, so, selector, on behalf of my wife and I, on behalf of my wife and I, my beautiful, sexy, oh, have mercy, right, wife, and I want to thank you. Yes. All right. We pull the phone, Mario, so we can. Where Mario gone? Mario, he left me eye and dry. Hey, Alex, remember, we can't do things, so yeah, back up. Alex, get the mic for me, Alex. What's the song? You know. You ready? So the name of the song is 'Cause I Love You. Alex, you have the mic? All right, good. Ready? Girl, you know I love you. No matter what you do, and I hope you understand me. Every word I say is true. 'Cause I love you. Oh. Someone needs a lot of women for their passion of to feel, but I only want you, girl. Wait, the track gone left me.
Continue.
I love Alex. I don't say are you not help me. Don't say fias. You know, let me tell you a story. You want to hear a story? All right, here it goes like this. I remember the first time I meet Sash. I'm a friend. Turn music. And I saw her at the Woodburn SDA church. You see, oh God, good. God carry her right on my door. Right? And I remember when I saw her, one of my friends said, you know what, this girl you're gonna marry though. He's not here today because he's overseas. He couldn't make it. But my friend looked at me and said, you know, is this girl going to marry? I look at him and I laugh. And I said, brother, what are you talking about? You know? What is you talking about? You know? But anyways, I went over my friends and I introduced myself. And when I introduced myself, she talked to me, you know, and when she talked to me and thing, she gave me her number, and I said, all right, then me, I get somewhere. Mr. Friends, I text her, you know, the Sabbath, you know, no reply. I text her the next week, no reply. I said, no, man, something wrong. Text the next week again, and no reply. So I call, and I say, you know, hey, you know, I was texting her. She said, oh, text me again. And friends, I text her again, and guess what? No reply. So, I say, you know what? I give up. I'm saying, you know what? Just be friends. And I remember one day I was driving past where she lived, you know, just passing. And I called and I said, "Is the womb?" And she said, "Yes, she's home." And I said, "All right then, cool." So I stopped by, you know, went upstairs, down in the kitchen, and we spoke. And when we start to talk, yes, I love to chat, but friends, this time whenever me alone there chat, right? And we spoke for 3 hours, right? 3 hours, you know. We talked about everything from family, go straight back to college. And when I finished talk, I just left. You know, we just leave. Still friends. Few months passed after, and I saw her again. And she was, you know, the spirit say, you know, it's full time. And you just ask a question and just get your know and go about your business, you know. So I was walking with her, and I said, "Sash, let me ask you a question. Yes or no? You like me?" And she said, "Yes." So at this time, I was shocked because I was just ready to take my no, because this young lady don't miss me for over 6 months, right? But she said yes, and from there, it has been until now, right? I'm finished now, but I'm going to actually... Alex actually spoiled that song. So I'm going to sing a song that I can sing. Alex, she's royal. I will sing that song because, Alex, you didn't help me a while ago. She's royal. Your voice gone. Brady, play She's Royal for me. Whoa, natural beauty. Yeah, yeah. Oh, I never seen someone shine until I see your eyes. Still I had to cry. Yeah. Oh, yes. Let me get the right words and just approach you. Let me treat you like a man is supposed to. You never have to cry. Yeah. I know everyone can relate to when you find that special someone. She's royal. Yeah. So royal. And I need her in my life. I never know anyone so one of a kind. Yeah. Until I see your eyes. Still I had to try, yeah. Even though it took me 6 months, I happy I still invest myself, yeah. She's royal, yeah, so royal. And I want her in my life. My brothers and sisters, that's a wrap.
All right. Let me just say thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, for coming out tonight for celebrating this momentous occasion. We ask you to be careful as you drive home, as we know the difficult terrains are hard to navigate. Be careful, take your time, and safe travel. Just in case you live far, don't worry, you're already dressed nicely, so you can go into work just the same. We thank you again. Have a on behalf of the Bedwards. And all those who came to celebrate tonight, we thank you. Have a good night.